For Vernon Ridge Glass Insulator Show, Springfield, Ohio.
Just kind of packed this one building full of glass insulators. I did one film down this wall, and then another one film this way. And I'm going to do like 3/4 of the building in this last film, I think. It's not really, if you've seen one, you've seen them all, but just to get an idea, I'm not trying to cover the whole thing. I'm just trying to get an idea of what's going on.
You can tell it's like mass-produced art, you know, and way up high.
So there's a lot of really nice people, and you can talk about anything you want with them. People from all over the country that are well traveled. And some really cool stuff that a lot of other people have never heard of it. More telephone. So some of these are communication. You guys brought your backpacks. I mean, they're packed too. Brookfield. I'd be from Connecticut or Rhode Island. Beautiful collars from padlocks. I don't know if I show up or not. It's just California. So that one surprised me. I didn't know we were talking in the 1800s, and there wasn't a whole lot out there at that time, was there? I don't know. Yeah, these guys are from New Mexico. Says Laughlin, because they don't have these shows out west that I'm seeing. They're all back east, but maybe I have to look some more. I don't know. Very valuable ones at this. Dollar table. $5 for $4. $8. $40. Canadian. little Coke containers that would organize them for you. Like that, he's got the yellow looking light instead of white. With a little softer light. They look like they almost have glitter in them, but it's like where they're rough.
I was gonna plug this in here.
Yeah.
Plug mine in here.
But how's that gonna help me over there?
I only have an extension cord.
You have one, and it's got one plug on the end.
Okay.
Oh, that's a free pile out front. I thought that was the auction stuff. I don't know. This is a long-running show. These guys are from Oregon. I noticed there's people here from Utah. Just... I mean, that's like $1,000 just to travel to and from, isn't it? I think it is, yeah. 1,000 each way. I'm doing pretty good covering. I keep moving. There's a big one. Run up, and we'll run up and back, and yeah, and then we gotta come. Should be halfway. Halfway through here. More railroad stuff. He's smiling. He's got that table full. Oh, this is a battery. These are batteries. That's why you didn't have an electric start on cars. You need an electrical system. $55 on it. On a, be 2 volts a cell. Really cool stuff here, man. There's an acid, and he's showing clean and unclean. Miniatures. Beautiful. Like $350 on them. Anaconda mine, Montana. Anaconda, Montana. That looks like a root. That's a root, isn't it?
Yeah, you know.
I think she's trying to scare us away as she's coughing. But, I want that postal. That's a pretty unique thing. I learned some stuff today.
Just sold about 10 minutes ago.
Seattle.
Who's this?
Claire from Seattle. So this one's 150 and that one's for 75? No, 175, okay. That's closer. I never did see the $12,000 one like I saw on eBay, but I know they have them here. Steel. There's no casting marks on there. Forged steel. Making glass in Ohio. It's like working in a steel mill, glass mill, I bet. Mason jar collection, extensive. McDonald's collectible. Yeah, not sure. $150 on a Sinclair. Some petrol. It's a cool little 7-Up. McLaughlin Manor House Coffee. Yep, down the last row here. $125 on this guy. Electric fence, I think, is what we use this for. Lots to cover. Now, here's a battery with a plates in it. $150 Waterbury. Another battery. Thanks for watching my videos, everyone. Bogart Rippey over here in Springfield.